Hey guys and gals, I'm here with a video. You can't tell from our little decoration, we are quickly approaching Halloween, and I figured why not take a look at NECA's 2018 Halloween Ultimate Michael Myers. This figure is like 2, if not 3 years old now. I didn't see him in retail until fairly recently. It was sometime this year, and I thought I'd put it off until October. I have not seen him in retail since. If you do want to grab this guy or any future NECA Halloween products, I know there's a Loomis Michael 2-pack from Halloween 2. There's a 2018 Laurie. There's a Halloween Kills Michael. I think there's a single release of Halloween 2 Michael coming out, if it's not out already. EnterEarth.com has all of them either in stock, up for pre-order, or they're restocking soon. I highly recommend going through them. I've never had a bad experience with Entertainment Earth. Whether or not I'll buy the Halloween Kills version of Michael, I'm really not sure. This is kind of my de facto Michael, at least for the time being. So here's the packaging. It's nice. If you don't want to take your figure out, you can have him displayed with a nice little window packaging. There he is, and there's a little tease in the back of what you can find inside if you do open your toys up. We don't keep things sealed around here, so here is Michael in all of his glory. I don't know if I have a favorite horror villain. It kind of goes back and forth. Michael has not had a great track record in terms of sequels. I think there are more bad movies than there are good in the Halloween series. That's just my two cents. But I love the overall look of Michael. Just, this is such a menacing figure on your shelf. NECA figures are typically a 7-inch scale. I think Ash is 7 inches. I haven't really measured him in a while. But you can see just how much Michael towers over him. He is definitely a force to be reckoned with. And he just stands out with his overall mass. He just looks great. We're gonna take Ash out just for now. So this is the Ultimate Michael Myers. He is fairly poseable for what you get. I mean, if you think back to the Michael Myers figure I covered maybe 10 years ago that had no knees, I don't think, or any leg articulation, NECA is up their game quite a bit. So articulation-wise, we're going to start off at the head. He does have a ball-jointed neck peg. You can see inside there. The head's got some decent degree of movement. You can, of course, turn it left and right, as you would expect. So you can just have Michael. I love the whole head tilt he sometimes does, just the, aww. Oh, that's there. The arms have full rotation at the shoulder. They can swing out to the sides pretty far. He does have a double hinged elbow, so you can get his arms going pretty far up. You can have him just kind of going, oh my God, what did I do? His wrist has up and down movements. I want to talk about the wrist peg in a bit. I'm kind of leery about it, but up and down movement, and the wrist can rotate because you can switch his hands out. His body, he does have this kind of soft, rubbery, kind of covered that older Ash had. I don't think there's any joint inside there. I've kind of moved this guy back and forth, and unless I just haven't cracked it, I can't find any kind of torso joints, waist movement, anything like that. So I think that's there just to help bulk him up a little bit, which I'm okay with. You get onto his legs, they can go pretty far forward because of this whole rubber piece. They can go back a fair bit, actually. He could do, believe it or not, Michael is an old man, but he can still pop a split like no one else's business. There is some rotation at the top there, so that's nice. You got onto his knees. He does have articulated knees, and his feet have, I think it's just a ball joint. I can't really tell. I don't want to take the whole thing apart. I'm not entirely sure, but there is forward and back movement. Oh, you know what? There it is. You can see the hinge just slightly under the cuff of his pants. So there is that, and then his feet can kind of have that kind of rocker articulation. He's not the most poseable figure in the world. NECA stuff is definitely more about sculpt than it is posability, but NECA has really upped their game in terms of what their figures can do, and I like it. He looks great. Hey, don't fall over. Here, let's get him just kind of in a, you know, there. We'll just get him kind of like that. He does kind of lean backwards if you don't get him balanced just right. As you can see, he's trying to go backwards. So let's just get him kind of propped on his feet. There we go, just like that. The Ultimate figures not only have improved articulation based on their older figures, they also have tons of accessories. The biggest, of course, is the tombstone for his sister Judith Myers, replicated quite nicely. You just put that right next to him. We, of course, get the jack-o'-lantern that I think Dave, was his name Dave, brought to Vicky. It does come pre-installed with batteries, so you can have that light up. My only My only complaint, and it might be a dumb complaint, I would like to be able to take this thing apart, and I don't really see how that's possible due to how it's made. I would like to have some kind of like film inside, so the light is spread out a little more evenly. As is, it's fine. It looks okay. I mean, it looks like a jack-o'-lantern. I like the overall flickering effect that they have, but I would have liked if there was something inside to help disperse the light so it covered everything evenly. That might just be a me complaint. You have the head of a sandwich cop. It is hollow on the inside, and if you found a small enough LED, you could have this lit up like it was in the movie. I would have liked if this could have had some kind of light-up feature, but I understand we're already getting the jack-o'-lantern, so... But the overall detail on that just looks great. Don't know Sandwich Cop's actual name. Didn't look it up. Don't really care. It's fine. And now we get into the real nitty-gritty, the stuff that you can customize your Michael if you so desire. I forget which head he came with initially, but he does have two. Let's hope I don't break this neck peg like I did Blade. So they are very, very similar in appearance. The main difference that I can see, if you look closely, this one has these shadows in his eyes. You can't see his eyes, whereas this one, you can actually make out his eyes inside, including the one that Laurie blinded him with, I think the coat hanger. So it's totally up to you which design you want. This one's hair is a little more ruffled, it looks like. So they are different sculpts. The face itself, if there's a difference, this one looks maybe like it's a little more bloated than this one. But I definitely like this one more. That's just my personal preference, but I like the option. If you're going to switch them out, it comes right off relatively easily. There's no ball joint. I don't have any concerns about this breaking. Unlike with Blade, just push it on, give a little twist, and there you go. There's your head on. Oh, we're just gonna put that right back there. Stand, big boy. We, of course, have weapons. It's Michael Myers. He's got to have weapons. He does have a bloody hammer, the classic butcher knife, and the fire poker. I'm going to be totally honest with you. I rewatched Halloween 2018 last night. I don't remember what he used the fire poker on. I don't know who he killed it with. I'm not totally fond of this, and I'll get to that more when I put it in his hands. This being so thin, I'm really worried it's going to break. I would have much preferred, instead of having this, if we could have gotten an alternate knife that had blood on it. I like having the clean knife. It definitely looks great. But you want to have a bloody knife too, much like they did with the bloody hammer. So Michael, of course, has to hold his weapons, which means he comes with, and again, I forget which hands he came stock with. But you can see his left and right hands are kind of in these more relaxed positions there. Whoop. He also comes with a more open left hand, which is nice and bloody. A set of hands that are for holding his weapons, which I will demonstrate in a little bit. So there's that one, and then there's that one. And then, of course, spoiler alert, Michael gets his hand shot. So he's missing some digits. It's fine. It's okay. Switching the hands out is relatively easy. I do have some concerns about them. They are these little teeny tiny pegs. And this is actually my second Michael Myers. The first one I got, pulling off his hands, immediately snapped the peg, which was not a really good feeling. I haven't had any problems since, but still, you want to be careful. If you want to heat these guys up in boiling water first, it definitely wouldn't hurt. But, so let's go ahead and switch out some hands. Let's go ahead and give him this one. And, like, it's fine. I don't feel like it's going to break, but still, with how little those pegs are, I am slightly concerned. But just give a little twist, and you should know when it's fully on. So I may do this off camera, just make it a little easier. And maybe it's just mine, but for this one hand, and it may be the others, but this one I've noticed the most. Listen closely, you can hear it does actually peg in place, but when you twist the hand, it comes right off. So I'm not entirely sure what's going on with this one. It definitely feels like it is fully pegging in, but it comes out incredibly easy, which I guess isn't really a bad thing. I guess I'd rather it come off easily than break. But so with these hands, you can now give Michael his weapons. Really, he holds them both equally as well in each hand. You can switch whether you want to have him hold the knives or hammers in his left or right hands, whichever. He holds them pretty well. My only real complaint is I feel like he doesn't hold the knife that well in this kind of angle. If you want to have him in like a stabbing motion, I can't get it wedged in his hand properly. I'm sure if I stretch his fingers out more, I could probably get it in there. But just by default, the blade likes to go in kind of at a crooked angle. You can't get it just kind of straight on into his hand, at least in my experience. I guess that's all right, but I don't know. I feel like he doesn't hold it properly. Maybe it's just me. The best way I can find to get him to hold the fire poker is to kind of take his hands. For me, it works better with his left hand. This one, the fingers feel stiffer, and I'm not sure if that's just my imagination, but these fingers are a lot harder to pry open than these, and then you just kind of thread it through his hand, and he can hold it okay. I don't love it. You can maybe even have it kind of, you know, he's just, here, let's just try to get it in his thumb. Yeah. That's real menacing. I'm just not a big fan of that accessory. I am fully convinced at some point the fire poker will break. That's just the way it works with me. So I'm going to put on his shot off fingers real quick, because we are about done. And I'm just trying to show you what it's like in real time. Yeah, I definitely didn't feel or hear the click. The biggest concern with this whole hinge is just the way it'll suddenly like move like this, and I'm just terrified I'm gonna put pressure on the wrong point and it's gonna wind up snapping. There we go, it's on. So now you can have Michael, you know, let's go ahead and give him his knife again. So let's just get him standing up there. And let's just see. I don't have a lawyer to shoot his fingers off. But what I do got is an old man with a boomstick. So we'll try to balance Ash. We'll see. He definitely was not meant for this kind of pose. But there you go. You can make some kind of display where maybe Ash is shooting off Michael's fingers. He's the only figure I have that actually has a bunch of guns. So there is that. I mean, that there's really not too much to say about this figure. I'm sure you've already watched a bunch of videos on it from 3 years ago. If you are a horror fan at all, you need to have a Michael Myers in your collection, whether it is this one, one of the older ones, or one of the newer ones. Maybe you want to buy the Halloween Kills version where he's got his mask partially burned off. It's totally up to you. I like this guy, and I'm totally glad that I picked him up. I think he looks great. And the more I mess with, the more I feel like maybe I do have to get a lawyer to go with him. I feel like for $35, you get a decent assortment of accessories. As I mentioned, I would have liked to have two versions of the knife, one bloody, one clean. I don't necessarily need the Judith Myers tombstone. I definitely think it had more of an impact in the first Halloween than it did in 2018. So it being there, it's nice, but I don't really need it for my display. It has no purpose. I like the pumpkin with the heart-shaped eyes and nose. I like having Sandwich Cop's face and, of course, the two versions of Michael's mask. I think NECA did a fantastic job with this Michael. And if you do want to pick it up, Intimate Earth either has them in stock or they're restocking fairly soon. But that's it for this video, guys and gals. I hope you've enjoyed it somewhat. If you did, you want to see more, I got stuff at the sides in the top where you can either subscribe or watch my previous videos. I have a Patreon and YouTube membership down below that can give you some bonus content. I hope you have a great day and a happy Halloween. I will see you around. Take care.